what do you reckon the chances of pinching one of the screw's car keys out?
Oh, Buckley's love. You have a better chance flying off the roof. Anyway, you're too young to drive.
Oh, don't bet on it. How do you reckon I got out of Winston Lee Girls' Home?
Oh, yeah? Well, how'd they catch you?
I ran into a hedge. Well, the principal didn't press charges, so I couldn't get arrested for that.
I'll tell you what, I've never known anyone as keen to get out of this place as you are.
Don't you think I want to get out of here?
Calm down. Let's go back
don't
to the room.
Don't come near me. I'm not going with you.
Come on, let's
I'm
go back
to yourself. I'm sick of never being told when to eat, when
quietly,
to sleep in this place.
Kids. Pull yourself together.
You lock me up in here and you take your kids away from me and you won't let me see my kids.
Let's...
No! Now just get away from me, you bitch!
Another fun morning at Winter.
If this is your idea of fun, I think you've got a very sick sense of humour.
And she attacked you without any provocation?
Yes, she just seemed to snap. One minute she was quite normal, next thing she went for me like a mad woman.
Well, Kent has been under a lot of strain lately, Mrs. Davidson.
I realise that, but there's no excuse for this sort of behaviour.
No, no, of course not.
Well, I'd like you to see a doctor. I'll call a car for you.
Oh, no, Mrs. Davidson, please, that's not necessary. I feel fine, really.
Well, I'd be much happier if you had proper medical attention.
Excuse me, Mrs. Davidson, I'd just like to check on Officer Bailey.
Oh, I'm okay, sister, just a bit of bruising, that's all.
Oh, that's good, but Mrs. Powell seemed to think it was more serious, so I'd better take a look.
What about Kent, sister? How is she?
Not good. She was quite hysterical, so I had to put her under heavy sedation. She'll probably sleep for a few hours now, and after that, we'll just have to wait and see.
Well, I'd like to see her as soon as she comes around, Mrs. Morris.
Yes, of course. I don't think she'll be any more trouble.
Well, I sincerely hope not. The VJ will be here to try Winter on those drug charges later this morning, and I don't want any further outbursts whilst he's here.
I don't want to end up like Hazel, Jude. It gave me the creep seeing her like that.
Yes, well, they've certainly got the deck stacked against her this time. Well, it's not the first time someone's cracked up. It won't be the last.
I've seen girls go around the twist before, but usually it was because they were junkies or silly as two bob watches to start with. But Hazel seems so...
So normal?
Yeah.
Yeah, and so she is. But this place gets to the best of us, you see. I'm not surprised it doesn't happen more often.
Yeah, well, I'm getting out of here before it happens to me.
Well, that's all well and good, dear, but I'd be careful who you talk to about it.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, for a start, let's take the last fiasco that you had. Didn't seem funny to you that Powell knew exactly where to look for you. She could have been tipped off, you know.
Nah, that was just bad luck. It was a dumb place to hide anyway.
Yeah, maybe.
Well, I reckon I could trust Lizzie and Mass with my life. And you too, Jude.
Thanks, love. You see, I don't think anyone would ever hurt you intentionally. It's just sometimes people say things without thinking. So just be careful who you talk to, okay?
You're the boss, Jude.
Well, if I'm the boss, move your butt, girl. We got work to do.
I reckon things are going to be pretty quiet around here without that ratbag Kent. Still, she'd probably brighten things up a bit in isolation. She and Peterson ought to get on real well together.
Shut up, Winter.
Don't be so touchy, Bryant. Hey, perhaps we can all chip in and buy her a straitjacket.
Why don't you creep back into the sewer? You'll feel more comfortable at home.
You're out of line, Bryant.
Yeah, so are you. Hazel's one of us, you know. Don't you have any feelings at all?
That's for me to decide. In the meantime, just watch who you're talking to and show a bit more respect.
Meaning what?
Meaning I'm taking over. Edwards ain't around anymore. And with Smith in isolation, she's not going to argue with me, do you reckon?
Well, excuse me, Your Royal Highness, but it's not that simple, you know. You can appoint yourself top dog, sure, but you have to have the support of the women to stay there.
Oh, don't worry. I'll get their support, one way or the other.
Well, what are you doing, Suze? Are you looking for something? Look, can you keep a secret, Mass?
Yeah, of course I can.
Well, what's going on? Well, I know this bloke on the outside. Well, he buys up scrap material. I thought he could use some of this stuff.
That'd be real good. But how are you going to get it to him?
I haven't figured that out yet. I guess we'd better do some work, okay?
Well, rightio.
Hear what I told Bryant?
Sir?
So I'm going to need you to back me up.
Look, if you want to go for top dog position, that's fine, but you can leave me out of it. I'm not crossing B. Smith again unless there's something very big in it for me.
Don't worry, there's going to be plenty of perks.
Sure, I've heard all that before. You got bucklers of getting any dope in here, and that's the only thing worth having.
Don't be too sure. Look, Smith ain't around anymore, neither's Edwards. So that just leaves me, right? You think about it.
Don't know what you're planning, but forget it. Winter, you're wanted in the governor's office.
Ah, you see, girls? Even the governor wants me advice.
Yes, very amusing. I doubt whether the VJ will find the charges against you quite so funny, though. Come on, move it.
Anything to get out of this rut.
The rest of you, you ought to be in the rec room at lunchtime for buy-up distribution. Now, come on, just hurry up with the work.
Hey, Mouse, take over the press, will you?
I'll see you later.
Hey, Mouse, well, what's
the rush? The buy-up, remember?
I want to get me chalky biscuits. I love chocolate. Hey, listen, have you ever been up on the roof?
The roof?
Yeah, once. Well, there was this riot, and we all went up there and burnt our mattresses and stuff. Only this kid, Leanne Burr, she went and fell off and got killed.
Oh, well, what's up there?
Well, how do you mean?
Well, what did you see on the roof?
Jeez, I don't remember. It was a while ago. Well, there were two big air vent things, I remember that.
From the air conditioning?
I suppose. Well, how come you're so interested anyhow?
Oh, no reason. Just curious.
Oh. How'd you go with the VJ?
Another 12 lousy stinking months. Half of it non-parole period.
Tough luck.
Yeah, luck had nothing to do with it. If that bitch Peterson hadn't given my letter to a stinking cop, it never would have happened. Just wait till I get my hands on her.
What you going to do to her?
You wait and see. By the time I finish with her, she's going to wish she'd never been born.
You busy?
Oh, no more than usual.
I was wondering if you'd made a decision about Hazel yet.
Well, to be honest, I've been putting it off as long as possible. I just don't know how the department's going to react. They're upset enough over the Sandy Edwards business.
Oh, is there any more word on that?
Well, she's been officially listed as an escapee. The police are still searching for her, but they're convinced she's gone to ground somewhere. And now this on top of everything else.
Well, Kent's not normally violent, and she's been under tremendous pressure over her children.
Oh, and I feel desperately sorry for her, but I can't just dismiss the charges against her.
No, I suppose not.
I shall be as lenient as possible. Why don't we wait and see what her condition is when she comes out of sedation?
Yes, but I think she's going to need help to get over this.
You mean psychiatric help?
Yes. I think Dr. Wiseman should see her.
Well, I've arranged for him to visit her as soon as possible. Let's hope it's as simple as that.
Come on, Bruce,
right. Hey, Angie. I'll swap you my fruit for your biggies.
Oh, what are you doing?
Nothing. I break out in spots if I eat fresh fruit.
Bull, you're laying in supplies, aren't you?
Look, I'm going to need all the food I can get my hands on when I get out of here, and fruit doesn't last.
Oh, you got a plan, Suze? Geez, I could help you if you like.
It's nothing definite, but I'll get out of here, you'll see. You could do something if you want to help me, Bud.
Yeah?
Well, what? Well, I've been rostered for the workshop, Sava. Do you reckon you could get me more of those material scraps?
Oh, of course I can.
Are you really going to give them to that bloke you know on the outside?
No, something like that. Well, don't worry. I'll get you as much as you like.
All right. Anybody who's missed out, that's too bad. Come on.
Righto, I'll take half of that.
What for?
Let's just say protection.
Protection from what?
From getting your head punched if you don't hand it over. Now give. That goes for the lot of you. If you know what's good for you, you'll cough up half every week.
I don't know what game you're playing at, Mari, but you give that stuff back right now.
Make me.
Don't you think I couldn't?
You and whose army? There you are, girls. I've told you there'd be perps.
That's good.
Righto, Bryant. You want to take on the lot of us, you're welcome to try.
Got to get to them. It's my kids. They need me. You don't seem to know. Oh, come on, open the door. Let me out of here. Oh, please, let me out of here. Oh, please, God. Don't let them do this to me.
Come on, ladies. No chatter. You're here to work, not talk.
Oh, but Mr. Marnie's not here yet, Mr. Powell.
Well, there must be something to do while you're waiting.
I suppose we could sort out the typeface.
Fine. Don't talk about it. Do it.
Need a hand?
Suit yourself.
Margot? Side in with Mari. You're not scared of her, are you?
I'm not scared of no one, kid. And I'm not on anybody's side except my own.
I don't know how anyone could back up Winter. She's just a big bully.
Well, someone's got to be the boss, and she's got what it takes. Look, I like to be on the winning team, see? So I help her, she helps me. You'll learn after you've been here for a while.
Yeah. Well, I hope I'm not around that long.
You stay here, supervise this lot. For God's sakes, keep them busy. We don't want any more trouble.
Come on, kid. Try and get up.
I'm gonna get out.
No, no, you don't.
Here we go again.
Sister.
Let's get on the bed.
Oh, please, I gotta see my kids.
Of course you do. You just have a little rest and you'll feel much better.
Oh, no! No! No!
That should hold her for a few more hours.
This is ridiculous. We can't keep doping her every time she wakes up.
Well, do you have any better ideas? Or perhaps you'd rather she ranted and raved all over the place until she hurts herself. Or anybody else who gets in a way, us included.
Hey, Bryant, you don't want to change your mind, do you? I can always use an extra heavy round here, and you're about as heavy as they come. What's the matter, fat stuff? Cat got your tongue?
Oh, don't, Jude. She's only doing it to get you going.
Hey, Bryant, if you want to talk to the governor, why don't you go and tell her the nasty lady's making fun of you?
You're wasting your breath, Winter, so stick it. I wouldn't lower myself.
Lower yourself? You're right at the bottom, Yank. That's as low as you can get. What do you reckon, girls? Do we need the kind of dingbat that lets herself get fooled by a stupid little hooker and winds up back where she started from? Saved by the bell. You'll keep with her. Any time, Brian, any time. All right, ladies, time to shut up shop.
Ah, suits me.
Trap, we finished for the day.
All righty-o, Mrs. Morris. Won't be a tick.
What on earth have you got there?
Where?
There.
Ah, there. Oh, just some scraps of material from the bin, Mrs. Morris.
So I see. The question is, what are you going to do with them?
Oh, well, I figured out no one wanted them and they'd just be thrown away. So I thought I'd make something. A patchwork quilt for me bed.
Well, I suppose it's all right. All the same, I think you should ask permission first. Remember that next time.
You mean I can keep it?
Don't see why not.
Oh, thanks, Mrs. Morris. You're a real brick. Hey, Suze! Oh, look what I've got. Honestly, Mash, you shouldn't creep up on people like that.
Oh, sorry. But I bought you a whole heap of scraps.
Oh, look. That's fantastic. Thanks, Mass.
Mrs. Morris caught me, but I told her I was going to make a patchwork quilt and she bought it. I can't even sew a button on.
Oh, what are you doing?
Nothing.
Oh, yes, you are. Oh, come on, I won't tell anyone.
Do you promise?
Of course I do. Well, what do you think I am?
It's a rope.
A rope? Well, what are you on a rope for?
Well, to get out of here, of course.
How are you going to do that?
Off the roof. I'm going to attach it to something up there and climb down the front of the building.
But that's dangerous. Oh, it's real high up there.
How high do you reckon?
100 foot. Oh, easy.
Then I'm going to need all the scraps I can get.
Oh, I just thought of something.
What?
Well, even if the rope does get you down, how are you going to get up there to start with?
Oh, I haven't figured that out yet.
I must say your report on Kent is very comprehensive.
Thank you, Mrs. Davidson.
However, I'm not convinced it is the whole story. That's why I've asked you both here to discuss it.
I'm sure you'll find all the facts are there.
Oh, yes, I'm quite sure. But facts quite often are only part of the story in these matters. Now, it does appear that Kent is emotionally disturbed. Would you agree, sister?
Well, it certainly looks that way. Her behaviour is quite irrational when the sedation wears off.
Yes, it's quite a problem. The department has agreed to my request to have Dr. Weissman examine her, but unfortunately he's interstate on sabbatical and they can't guarantee when he'll be available.
So what do we do in the meantime?
Well, we can keep her under sedation, but that's not advisable. Personally, I think she'd be better off back in her own cell where things are familiar to her. It seems to be the surroundings in solitary that are distressing her.
Sorry, I disagree.
Oh, why?
She's obviously violent. I don't think we should give her the chance to make further attacks on us or the other prisoners.
The chances of further violent attacks are fairly remote. And Sister Franklin does have a point about keeping her in solitary.
Mrs. Davidson, she attacked an officer.
I haven't forgotten that. But I do think we should spare her further punishment until the VJ has heard her case.
I agree. The poor woman suffered enough.
We'll move her to her cell in the morning. And I shall leave the medication to your discretion, sister.
And how exactly do we stop her flying at the other women as she has done with us?
By keeping her away from them, Mrs. Powell. Prevention has always been better than the cure.
Come on, Kent. You're going back to your cell.
You know something? I think I prefer it the other way.
Trap?
I'm here, Mrs. Morris.
Where's Bryant? Is she back yet?
Oh, here I am, Mrs. Morris.
God, how could you miss anything that size?
That'll do.
Hey, Bryant, can we use you as a windbreak during exercise bit? I said that's enough.
Bloody hell. Talk about the living dead.
Keep your chin up, honey. Things will be all right. We're all with you.
Jeez, she looks real terrible.
Come on, Ken.
She didn't know who we are. She didn't know any of us.
I reckon I've got things going pretty well how I want them around here.
A few biscuits and smokes isn't going to make any of us any rich. The real money's in the dope and you know it.
Patience, Margot, patience. We've got to make a bit of bread before we can get any new deals going.
Yeah? And how are we going to do that?
Simple. I'm going to start running a book. With the odds heavily in my favour.
But you can't do that.
Can't I?
Look, I've always taken the bets around here. That is my territory.
It was your territory. Now I'm taking it over. Any objections?
Yeah. What's the use?
Oh, stop moaning. You'll get your share as long as you do as you're told.
Right. Pile of mending to be done. Make yourself useful at the machine. And iron things. I'll be back later.
Well, well, well. Look what just crawled out of the woodwork. Anyone know where the scissors are? Oh, I don't think you're going to be needing the scissors, Doc. You're going to be loading the dryers.
But Mrs. Powell...
You've been away too long, Peterson. I'm running things around here now. Ain't that right, Margot?
That's right.
I see.
And I say you're going to be loading the dryers.
You're in charge?
Yeah, that's right. And don't you forget it.
Okay, you get to... Not too late. Well, is there a barrel of laughs this morning?
Yeah, well, it's this Hazel Kent business. It's got us all upset, me included.
Gonna have to do something about it. Well, come on, ladies. Get your chins up off the floor. It's all right for you lot. You're standing behind those faces. I have to look at them.
We don't feel much like smiling this morning, Mr. Marnie.
Yeah, everything's rotten in here.
Oh, that's no excuse. Things could be much worse. I think of Mrs. Barry. Poor Mrs. Barry, when she lost her glasses, she didn't carry on like this.
She didn't look too bloody happy last time I saw her.
Well, that's natural enough. Mrs. Davidson put her straight there. Really, Mrs. Barry, just because you've lost your glasses doesn't mean you have to make a spectacle of yourself.
Good, you're a real
tonic,
Mr. Marley.
And that wasn't all, because then she stumbled over to the car, half blind, remember? Opened the door and got into the back seat by mistake. Well, for a start, she couldn't find out where she had put the key, where were the pedals, and by the time I got there, she was screaming at the top of her voice, those wretched women have stolen my steering wheel.
Mr. Marley. What precisely are you instructing these women in?
Just a bit of light entertainment. To brighten things up a bit.
That's not what you're being paid for.
Oh, Mr. Marnie was just trying to
cheer. I am not interested in what Mr. Marnie does. However, I am interested in why you, being in charge, should allow this tomfoolery.
Well, you see, Mrs. Powell,
outside, if you don't mind. Shut up, Birdsworth. There is absolutely no excuse for being party to that kind of behaviour. It's hard enough keeping the women in line at the best of times without encouraging them with second-rate vaudeville routines.
It wasn't like that at all. He was just trying to cheer them up.
Yes, I might have expected you to defend him. But you know perfectly well that his behaviour was a serious breach of prison discipline. You had no right to allow it to continue, no matter what your personal feelings are.
My only concern, Mrs. Powell, is for the women and their morale. Now, they were too depressed to even work until Ian snapped them out of it. My personal feelings do not enter into this. I just thank God that there are people like Ian Marnie who care about other human beings.
It's not his job to look after morale.
Well, maybe it should be. All right, so the women were noisy, but I've never heard of any trouble breaking out when they were busy laughing, have you? And now, if you'll excuse me, Mrs. Powell, I would like to get back to my job. All right, ladies, that's the end of the show. Would you get back to work, please?
Miss Conway, do I have to go to lunch?
Well, aren't you hungry?
Well, it's not that. It's just I feel a bit crook.
What's up, love? None of your business, Lizzie. Driscoll's just feeling a bit off colour, that's all.
It's those cramp pains again, Lizzie. You remember?
Yeah, I remember, like the ones you had last time.
Yeah, well, you better go and lie down. If you don't feel any better after lunch, report to Sister Franklin, all right?
Thanks, Miss Conway. Bye, Lizzie.
Yeah, see you later, love. Now, you look after yourself. Poor little bugger. expect she'll feel better after she's had a few hours of peace and quiet.
Yeah, I expect so, Lizzie.
Me? Myself? Oh, I wouldn't miss out on my tucker for quids.
Edible, just.
Oh, good. Then we all have some. Yeah. And you can be the waitress. Go and get us four plates of food now.
I don't think she heard you, Murray.
I heard her.
Well, you better get moving, hadn't you?
You're not helpless, Winter. Get it yourself.
You're in enough strife, Peterson. Now go and do as you're told, or I might have to deal with you before I'm good and ready. Go and get us four plates of food now.
You heard her, Winter. Get it yourself.
Well, a bugging good old bee. Now you'll see the sparks fly.
What's the matter, Murray? You've got a bit pale. Lost your appetite?
Not me. But you might, Navani, when you find out about the changes around here.
You mean like you being top dog? Well, thanks for keeping my place warm for me, but now you can crawl back under your rock.
I'm on top, Smith, and I'm going to stay that way.
Well, you might like to try it, but you'll need plenty of muscle to support you.
I've got the muscle all right, haven't I, girls?
Oh, you mean Laurel and Hardy? You've got to be kidding. And what about you, Margot? Haven't you got something else to do?
Sure, B. Whatever you say.
Oh, well, now I've done my good deed for the day and saved you from the Wicked Witch of the North. How about getting me some lunch? See, Murray? That's how it's done. Just haven't got the right neck.
One thing, the Long Ranger couldn't have timed that better.
Looks like I arrived in the nick of time, Tonto. I believe Mari's been giving everyone a hard time.
Yeah, I think she's running for Dictator of the Year award. She's come down on all of us like a ton of bricks. We're all too scared to make a move.
You scared?
Well, you know how us Indians like to keep the peace, Kemosabe.
Tell me, What about her?
Her? Well, she's just got out of solitary, but there's trouble brewing. Mari's got her earmarked. That's just a matter of time.
Well, Winter will have to stand in a queue. What I don't understand is why Sandy didn't step in and stop all this. If anyone was going to take over, I figured it'd be her.
Haven't you heard?
Well, heard what? Now, come on, Jude. What's all the mystery?
Well, she's gone.
Gone? You mean escaped?
That's the official story, but some of us don't believe it.
What do you mean?
Well, she just disappeared. You know, I mean, literally disappeared. One minute she was there, the next minute she was gone. Now, Kate was the only one with her when she disappeared, and she claims she escaped.
Oh, did she now?
Yeah, and Mari reckons that somehow Kate killed her and got rid of the body.
Poor Sandy. I wouldn't put anything past Peterson. But if it's true, she's pushing her luck.
Yeah, well, now you know why Mari has it in for her.
Well, Mari's had to wait a turn. I have my own plans for Dr. Peterson.
What bitch, ought to break your bloody neck! Oh, keep away from me, Winner. I don't owe you nothing.
You two-faced lying hypocrite. You only joined up with me for what you could get out of it.
So what if I did? You don't think any of us would follow you just because we like your face, do you?
Look, I told you I'd take care of you and I will. You can have half of everything. But if you foul me up, then I'll really take care of you, and that's a promise.
Yeah? And who are you going to get to keep me in line? Now that Smith's back, no one will have a bar of you. She's got one advantage you'll never have.
Now what's that?
The women like her. She doesn't have to heavy them to get them to follow her.
Look, I don't give a damn about Smith. You just stick with me and Stokes and
Kiddo. And we'll have the whole bloody prison down on our necks. No way. I'm looking out for myself, no one else. You're on your own.
You better listen, you better listen. I can take care of you all by myself, and that goes for the others too. Now, unless you want a mouthful of broken teeth, you better do exactly as you're told. And you can tell that to Stokes and Cavelli as well.
You mean you don't know any news?
No, not a thing. Haven't even spoken to Lizzie. How is she?
What can I tell you? Lizzie's always Lizzie. She's okay, I guess. A bit worried about Hazel, we all are.
What's Hazel been up to?
She's in a bad way, love. George has dumped her. She's taken off with some housekeeper, and now they're going for custody of the kids.
You're kidding. Well, Hazel's not going to stand for that.
Well, what can she do about it? You should have seen her when she found out about it. I thought she'd go crazy. She tacked off with her Bailey. They've got her zonked out on drugs all the time. She looks pathetic.
Poor kid. I better have a talk to her. You know, I am beginning to wish I stayed in isolation. Sounds like it's been fun all the way, hey?
Yeah, well, it has been more depressing than usual. Except for Susie, of course. She's always good for a laugh.
What's she been up to?
2 escaped attempts, would you believe?
2? She doesn't waste any time, does she?
The first time she tried to get out of here on a forged pass. She had Officer Barry's glasses, couldn't see a thing, stuck out like a sore thumb and nearly walked into the fence.
The kid's got more eyes than glass. What else did she try?
The second time she tried to get out in the garbage bin. Pal found her under this heap of garbage and she stank like a pig.
She's a funny kid. She's going to have to watch herself. If she doesn't plan things more carefully, she's going to end up in trouble eventually.
G'day, B. Good to have you back.
Ta. Girl's been giving you a hard time.
Nothing I couldn't handle. Well, where's our little ray of sunshine?
Oh, you mean Susie?
Oh, she's feeling a bit crook, so Miss Conway told her go and lie down. She's just got growing pains or something.
Yeah, that's right, but I told her to report to sick bay after lunch if she wasn't feeling well. Has anyone seen her?
No, Miss Conway.
I better go and check.
Okay, ladies, let's see if we can set up a whole page, shall we?
What is Susie up to?
God, I don't know. She just wanted the Arvo off so she could plan her escape or something.
Well, on her own? Well, where is she now?
I don't know. She could be in Timbuktu for all I know.
Ridiculous. It's like a bloody hothouse in here.
So pretend you're an orchid.
Obviously the air conditioning isn't working.
Obviously. Well, it would help if you turned that press off for a while. It's steamy enough in here as it is without you adding to it. You got pretty cocky since Smith came back, haven't you? You don't even think she's going to protect you. Why don't you just leave me alone? Oh, I'm not going to touch you. Am I, Margot?
How should I know?
Listen, Gaffney, if I want Peterson sorted out, you better jump to it or else.
Shove it, Mary. I'm sick of you barking out orders.
I'm warning
you. No, I'm warning you. We only followed you because of the dope we could get out of it. Nothing else. Well, there's no dope, so you're on your own.
You got a pretty short memory, Gaffney. You seem to have forgotten that little talk we had earlier.
That's where you're wrong. I haven't forgotten any of it. Get up. Oh. Oh. See what you've gone and done? You got me all steamed up. You lay a finger on me again, or even look sideways, and I'm gonna make sure you get a flat head instead of just a fat one.
Screw's coming.
Let her up.
All right, what's going on in here? Going on. It's not what's going on, it's what's coming off. Bloody kilos of it. The air conditioning's broken down. It's like a sauna bath in here.
Yeah, it is a bit hot. I'll check it out. Meanwhile, stay away from the press. It'll only add to the heat. Come on, find yourself something useful to do.
Susie, you awake?
Oh, God. Stuffy in here today.
Yeah. Smell of that oil and printer's ink is not doing my stomach any good either. AB, don't you reckon we should cook up some sort of a story for Susie? You know, to put the screws off the scent so that she can make a getaway?
Well, how the hell can we when we don't even know where she is?
Well, if she used up all that scrap material, she should...
What are you on about?
Oh, nothing. I better get some more printer's ink.
Hey, come on, this isn't a tea break.
Oh, have a heart, Mrs. Powell, we're melting.
That'll be an improvement.
Well, I think it's unhealthy for us working under these conditions.
Oh, thank you, Dr. Peterson. Until you're instructed otherwise, you'll continue with your work.
No way, we're on strike.
Yeah, sit down, strike.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. The maintenance men will be here in half an hour.
Okay, how about we compromise? We'll go back to work in 30 minutes.
All right, not much point in you sitting around in this heat. Come on, take your exercise period early. Oh, come on, get moving.
Well, it's sure good to be out here.
Well, what's it like in the laundry?
It's murder. I think another 10 minutes in there, I would have lost 20 pounds.
Oh, I'm glad it wasn't me. I'd have disappeared. Oh, there's old Conway. I wonder if she's twigged.
Twigged?
Miss Conway, I'm worried about Susie. She might have passed out somewhere, or she might
Stop worrying, Lizzie. I just looked in on her, and she's fast asleep.
Well, what do you know? Well, I'll pop in and see her after I've finished work.
Oh, no! Look, he's just arrived.
Oh, damn it. I was hoping we could stay out in the sun all afternoon.
Hey, Mrs. Powell! Why don't you tell him to come back tomorrow? We're in no hurry, are we? Right.
Hi. Got a spot of bother with your air conditioning?
Yes, there's no air getting through at all.
Yeah, and you can't open too many windows around here, eh?
How long do you think you'll be?
Oh, well, probably a blockage. You wouldn't believe the muck and gunk that get in those filters. But don't worry, we'll clean it out for you. Have it fixed in no time.
Oh, good. Now, the other thing is, how much space are you going to need? Because I'd prefer it if the women could get back to their work.
Oh, no worries. As I recall, we'll have to check the laundry, but otherwise we can do it all from the plant room.
You can clean the whole system from there?
Sure. Oh. You use a machine that sends a blast of chemicals backwards through the whole ducting system. Melts everything away. Oh. You better keep the girls out of the laundry. Don't want to kill anyone, do we?
Thanks. Right. All of you from the laundry, you can stay out here a while longer. The rest of you are back to work.
Help! Help somebody! I'm stuck! Oh, please make someone hear me! G'day, Pete. Where'd you get to? It was beauty outside.
I decided to have a lie down instead. How come you're back so soon?
Oh, bloody fix-up men arrived.
Right. Now, where did we leave off?
Shh. Listen. What's that?
Yeah, I can hear it too. Sounds like someone banging and talking on the pipes.
Probably the maintenance men. Bit noisy, aren't they?
Yeah, better get used to it. Those air conditioning ducts carry sound for miles, just like a telephone.
A telephone? Come on.
No, that's true. If you want to telephone someone in C block, you just dial STAD.
What?
Straight through the air duct.
You sure it's going to work?
Well, we always try it first. And if it doesn't, then we'll start taking things apart. So let's hope it'll work, eh?
Susie must have put one over the screws properly this time. Miss Conway says she's lying down real sick.
Yeah,
this must be part of the plan.
She tried that sickness routine before. It didn't work. What I'd like to know is what Mouse was on about. What do you reckon?
Bugger if I know.
I think it's about time we found out. Oi. Hey, Mouse. What do you know about Susie's plans?
Me? Oh, I don't know nothing.
Come on, she's up to something. Give.
All I know is she's made a long rope and she's going to climb down from the roof.
The roof?
Well, how's she going to get up there?
Well, I don't know. She asked me what was up there, that's all.
And what did you tell her?
I told her there was two big air vent things. Well, that's all I could remember.
How much longer?
Oh, not long. He's just about to give it a blast.
Let me know when you're finished, will you?
It's getting hotter than ever in here.
That's it. That's why there's no air. Susie's in the air shaft, a clever little bitch.
Cool. You gotta stop them. I heard their maintenance men talking. They're gonna shove some chemical stuff or something up them pipes.
Oh, my God.
Hey, B, need an opposite.
Spitz, what are you doing here alone?
The chemicals, you gotta stop them. Susie Driscoll, she's in the ventilator shaft.
God.
Again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare. When morning comes around.